What's going on, you guys? Welcome back to the channel. I am Second Chance, and today we're watching American Psycho. American Psycho is a book-turned-movie written by author Bret Easton Ellis. It follows the life of a gentleman who lives a double life, who is going to be struggling to keep up appearances and balance out his sanity. I'm not going to keep you guys in suspense waiting for the reaction to start. There's not really much to plug here, but before we do, I just want to quickly say thank you guys for subscribing. Since my last video, we have jumped up, I want to say 14 subscribers, which is absolutely amazing. I'm truly, truly grateful, truly, truly thankful. And one of you guys put a comment on my video for The Room. You have no idea how much that comment meant to me, how much it means to me. It's not hard to sit here and record, and anybody who tells you that it is lying. But it is hard to sit here and record multiple videos back to back for upwards of 7 or 8 hours a day, then spend another 4, 5, 6, 7 hours editing the video. You guys have to remember something. This is content that is not ours. And for the sake of commentary and entertainment with our reaction videos, we're able to put these videos out. But there is a respect and there's a guideline that has to be followed every time you do this. So editing, for instance, this movie is 1 hour and 41 minutes long. You watching this reaction video, it may only be 30 minutes. Most of it will be me probably just talking. And to sit here for that amount of time and edit that takes time. And sometimes you don't always know if it's appreciated. You don't often know if people even recognize just what you're doing. But the fact that there was somebody who actually took the time to not only comment on one of my videos and say that they enjoyed my reaction, but they truly believe in my ability to grow this channel, that means so much to me. That shows me that not only is my hard work paying off, but I'm on the right track. And it feels wonderful to be on that. So to the gentleman, I want to get your name, actually. I want to get the commenter's name. I don't want to just keep saying the gentleman. Hopefully I'm saying this right. Rhodes Leo Loranda. I hope I said that correctly. And if I didn't, I apologize for butchering that. Thank you so much for your comment. I'm usually up until about 9 a.m. editing a video because it takes so much time. But last night I decided to go to bed. I went to bed at about 3 in the morning. I've only slept about 4 hours. And I woke up, I was gonna go back to sleep and legitimately saw that comment. And I was like, you know what? Get up and keep going, because this is going to pay off. That comment right there was that like, you're doing good, kid. Keep going. So thank you, Lorena. I'm so sorry. Thank you so much for your comment. I truly, truly, truly appreciate it. Okay. With that being said, let's go ahead and get into the movie. I don't like that. I already don't like this. It's that chorus, that single chord.
Lucky Jew bastard.
Ooh. Jesus, McDermott, what does that have to do with anything?
Yeah, I've seen that bastard sitting in his office, talking on the phone to the CEO, spinning a fucking menorah.
Not a menorah. You spin a dreidel.
Stop being a racist asshole. With
the exactly. Remarks.
Stony on the rocks.
These aren't good anymore. It's a cash bar. Only $25.
You're a fucking ugly bitch. I want to stab you to death and then play around with your blood.
I'm pretty sure we've all had our moments where we've thought, not exactly that, but for a brief second, you've had that thought in your head, like, yo, this is what I want to say to you. This is what I want to do to you because you're so incredibly rude. And I'll admit, she $25, that's rude on its own. But her demeanor was very, very, very unkind. All he did, like, he was going to pay the way that he was used to paying. Just tell him that, okay, you know, our policies have changed. This is how you got to pay.
In the morning, if my face is a little puffy, I'll put on an ice pack while doing my stomach crunches. I can do 1,000 now.
Wow. Good stuff, man.
And then feel flesh gripping yours, and maybe you can even sense our lifestyles are probably comparable. I simply am
it
not.
It really looks
there.
Like he just peeled his face off. Like the Patrick Bateman, the worker, he just peeled his face off, and Patrick Bateman, the killer, came out. I have to assume he's the killer given what he just said. Is that what he's listening to while he's walking? I'm not saying way. I'll be walking around with the stone face on, and the whole time I'll be sitting there playing like Just Glenn Hold My Hand.
Oh, wait.
And I need reservations for two at Arcadia at 8 o'clock on Thursday.
Something He's romantic?
Very busy life.
No. Silly.
Does she like him?
You look nice today.
That answered my question?
He said, do not wear that outfit again. Wear a dress, a skirt or something. And high heels. I like high heels.
If she really comes in there dressed that way because he simply said to, that's crazy. And you know what's funny? There is a sense of control that he clearly likes to have. It's not uncommon for serial killers to express a particular type of way of being. On top of that, they're very, very, most of them are very well put together. On the surface, they look normal. But beneath that, they have a very controlling type of exterior. Like, notice, he told her to wear something specific the exact way he likes for the sake of appeasing him.
See why you just don't quit.
Because I want to fit in.
His honesty is not that of a person that doesn't pick up on social cues. His honesty is that of a person that is very much like, this isn't who I am. I'm pretending to be this way for the sake of fitting in. It's crazy.
I'm fairly certain that Timothy Bryce and Evelyn are having an affair.
Okay, so he sees it.
I'm almost completely indifferent as to whether Evelyn knows I'm having an affair with Courtney Rawlinson, her closest friend.
He's wildly observant, but even with his observations of everybody, you notice that he's keeping tabs for the sake of knowing thy enemy, almost. Like, he doesn't like them. He socializes for the sake of fitting in, but he does it for appearances.
Sorry. Unless materialism in young people.
That's wild, because it's crazy how articulate he is and how well he gives his thoughts, but it sounds rehearsed. It doesn't sound real. It's crazy. He's very good. He's very, very good. And Christian Bale is killing this. I haven't even been watching that long, and already it's amazing. He's very, what was that guy named? Ted Bundy? He's very Ted Bundy-like. You lower your guard with him. He doesn't creep you out. He doesn't come off, like, it's a day's world, he would come off very creepy. But at that point, he's a handsome guy, very relaxing. It makes it very easy to just go along with him.
Hey, these are very expensive sheets, and I really need to clean them.
If you don't shut your fucking mouth, I will kill you.
Yeah, she knew that. She knew that. She understood nothing else he said.
This is Dorothea?
Good evening.
Yes, dear.
No, it's not. You couldn't get a reservation.
You're gonna have the peanut butter soup.
Thanks, Patrick.
She's so spaced out of her mind, she probably didn't even hear what he said. So is this normal for you, bro?
Hello, Halberstram.
Whoa, look at Jared.
Is that a gram?
New card. What do you think?
Whoa. Very nice.
Running over business cards. I'd like that, man.
Look at this.
That is really nice.
A penis swinging contest about business cards. Like, that's a new level of, like success. Like, we'd be out here trying to, like, well, who got the bigger TV? Who got the best fridge? Who got the best item in their fridge? These are like, who got the best business card? That's the type of success I'm trying to have. So me and my boys go at it about business cards.
Let's see Paul Allen's card.
Why is it so tense?
Look at that subtle off-white coloring. The tasteful thickness of it. Oh, my God. It even has a watermark.
Something wrong?
Yeah, what just happened?
You're sweating.
His card was better than Bateman's card. Alan's card was better than Bateman's card. And because it was better, in that instance, there's somebody out there better than him. And he doesn't like that.
You're kind. You're a kind man.
It's okay.
I can tell. Please.
You know what a fucking loser you are?
What?
Hmm?
It was that flipping business card that triggered him.
I feel lethal, on the verge of frenzy. I think my mask of sanity is about to slip.
Yeah, he doesn't even view himself as human. He views himself as something portraying a human, which is why he kills so easily. He didn't even hesitate. However, when something starts to break that facade. Okay, I think I'm piecing it together little by little. When something starts to chip away at his facade, That's when that sweat happens.
I'm very sorry, sir.
JMB straight and a Corona.
Would you like to hear the
double absolute martini?
Yes, sir. Would you like to hear the specials?
Not if you want to keep your spleen.
That's aggressive. That's wild aggressive.
I think she's having dinner with Evelyn Williams.
Evelyn! Great ass. Goes out with that loser Patrick Bateman. What a dork.
Oh, Paul, you just messed up. Look at the floor. He's sitting. I'm choking because I'm realizing what's happening. All the furniture is covered. Remember at the dry cleaning, he had a sheet covered in cran apple. The furniture's covered.
Look at that. Crisp sound.
Furniture's covered. There's paper on the floor, and my boy has an axe in the bathroom. Oh boy.
Why are there copies of the style section all over the place? Do you have a dog?
No, bruh. If you take one look behind you.
Is that a raincoat?
Yes, it is.
This is the most excited I've seen him all movie. It's so crazy. When he gets into killer mode, he gets very, very animated. It's very Jim Carrey-like.
Hey, Paul!
Night-night. He killed the guy in the alley because Alan caused him to snap. He killed Alan because Alan and Waze was better than him. So we're gonna ignore that he's doing this. Look at the floor. What is this life?
When I realized that Paul's apartment overlooks the park, and it's obviously more expensive than mine.
There it is, right there, like I said. Paul was better than him. In his eyes, Paul is better than him simply because of the fact that Paul has more.
He was part of that whole Yale thing.
Yale thing?
Yeah, Yale thing.
What Yale thing?
Well, I think from one that he was probably a closet homosexual who did a lot of cocaine.
That's a crazy accusation.
You'll have to excuse me. I have a lunch meeting with Cliff Huxtable.
Isn't Cliff Huxtable a fictional character from The Cosby Show? Know me by now. You will never, never, never know me.
I want you to clean your vagina.
I was not expecting him to say that. Oh my God, what did he do to her?
Good personality consists of a chick with a little hard body who will satisfy all sexual demands without being too slutty about things and who will essentially keep her dumb fucking mouth shut.
Let me tell you, in certain circles, these are exactly how those conversations go. I've witnessed these conversations. Never been a part of them, but I have witnessed these conversations.
I decided to get a new one too.
No, don't do that. Uh-oh, no. Oh, that is really nice. That is really nice. That green with the off-white and the golden letters, that's actually really nice. I never thought I'd be into this business card that much, but I'm actually really into it. Well, good luck explaining that. Holy shit. Holy shit, he's washing his hands with gloves on.
Ask me a question.
Ask me a question, that's wild, bro.
What do you do?
I'm into,
finance?
Well, murders and executions mostly.
Do you like it?
Well, it depends. Why?
Well, most guys I know who work in mergers and acquisitions really don't like it.
She didn't hear what he said. He said murder and execution. She said mergers and oh shit.
Where do you want to go? Anywhere you want, just say it. I can get us in anywhere.
If she says Doris, what's it called? Demoris? Drowsies?
Dorsia?
There it is. The one place he can't get into.
Patrick, it's so elegant. What a wonderful view.
Jean?
Oh! Whose head was that?
I'm at a point in my life where there seems to be so many possibilities.
Very.
But I'm just so unsure.
That's crazy. So many possibilities, and then it shows him playing with the knife. The way they're framing this is so cool. The way they're shooting it is amazing.
Now I've really begun to think about changing myself, you know, developing and growing.
He's really trying to decide what items he wants to use against us. us. I said us. Her.
According to his date book, and this was verified by his secretary,
he went out with you to
have dinner with Marcus Halberstam.
Oh, that's right. He doesn't know his name. Paul keeps kept calling him Marcus. He didn't know his name was Bateman.
At Atlantis. With Craig McDermott, Frederick Dibble, Harry Newman, George Butner, and...
sweat.
You.
Look at his face. Look at the veins.
I mean, to think that one of his friends killed him for no reason whatsoever would be too ridiculous.
No reason to you, but a major reason for Patrick. He thought he was better than him. Patrick thought Paul was better than him, so therefore he killed him. Oh, same girl? Girl, run. Run, girl. Girl, he got a head in the freezer. Run. She made it out. Patrick, you screwed up, my boy. You screwed up, bro. There you go. That's exactly what you do. That's exactly what you do. You just run around screaming. Somebody, you'll get somebody's attention. There's no way. He got her? He got her. Uh-oh. Feed me a stray cat.
Stop that.
Should've mind your business, lady. Should've mind your business. I refuse to believe that this is how this movie ends. Oh, shit. Oh, no. I don't want it to end like this. Please, just like come to your senses at the ATM. There's no way he just killed four police officers.
Midnight oil, Mr. Smith. Hey, now don't forget to sign in.
Mr. Smith. Oh my God, he snapped. Whoa. He snapped. He's gone on a spree. He's officially gone on a spree.
You're my lawyer, so I think you should know I've killed a lot of people. Some escort girls in an apartment uptown. Some homeless people, maybe 5 or 10.
Oh my gosh. What are you about to say? There's nothing that you can say that's worse than that.
I ate some of their brain.
Okay. I really take that back.
Davis. I'm not one to badmouth anyone. Your joke was amusing. But come on, man. You had one fatal flaw. Because I had dinner with Paul Allen twice in London.
What is going
on? 10 days ago.
No, you...
There's no... What is happening?
But even after admitting this, there is no catharsis. My punishment continues to elude me. And I gain no deeper knowledge of myself.
Right.
No new knowledge can be extracted from my telling.
None at all.
This confession...
It means you admit nothing.
Nothing.
But that's not true, because your secretary knows. Whoa, is there more? That's it. Whoa, what a movie. That was absolutely insane. First of all, it was amazing from beginning to end. I thoroughly enjoyed that. It's amazing to me. So he's a man who pretends to be that of a human. Like, he's not inhuman, he's human, but his facade is not that. I mean, his facade is human, but his internal makeup isn't, meaning he's very much a guy who's unemotional, unavailable, very much gets off on the pain of others. And even though he went on a whole spree, murdered four cops, shot an old lady, popped some security guard in the head, popped a cleaner in the head, told on himself, and then the next day his lawyer's like, oh, yeah, I got your message, but it was a joke. He called him Davis. Paul Allen called him Marcus. They don't even recognize him as Patrick. His co-workers recognize him as Patrick. His secretary knows he's Patrick, and the detective did nothing more than just basically damn near accuse him of murdering of Paul, which he wasn't wrong about, but there was no follow-up on it. And I don't think there was meant to be. I think the detective's point was to cause Patrick to unravel a little bit more. And it's wild to watch that happen. And I love the part where he said, even after doing this, there's no catharsis. There's no, you know, learning more about myself. I don't understand why I'm doing this. I don't understand why I want to do this. I confessed to murdering these people. Not only did I confess to it, but I confessed to enjoying it. And Nothing's happened. There's no punishment for me. I'm not getting arrested. I'm not going to jail. There's nothing happening to me. I openly admit that I did this. And nobody's done anything about it. So I'm going to continue to do it. And that's the difference. Like they mentioned Ed Gein. He mentioned Ted Bundy. What's his name? Jeffrey Dahmer, John Wayne Gacy. The difference between all of those American Psycho killers is that they all got caught because of a mistake. He made the mistake and didn't get caught. And you can immediately see the switch. That facade doesn't matter anymore. He doesn't care anymore about holding up the facade. When they asked him his thoughts, he literally said, whatever. He doesn't care anymore. He's going to go on a spree. All of New York from that point on is dangerous, is in danger. He's gonna hurt a lot of people, man. Wow, what a viewing. American Psycho. That was a great movie. That did not feel like an hour and 41 minutes. I felt a lot shorter. That was enjoyable from beginning to end. All-star cast, amazing acting, wonderful writing, kept you guessing. And I got my wish. He didn't go out that way. I wanted him to get caught. I really, really did, but I didn't want him to get caught like that. I felt like if he was gonna get caught, it needed to be a lot better. But turns out he didn't even get caught. The man told on himself and nothing happened. And most people don't even know who he is. He pretends to be somebody and gets triggered by people believing that they're better than him. I was really hoping for a follow-up on that Lewis storyline. Not the sexual aspect of it, but like, if he killed him or not. But nothing ever came of that. So I think that was just more so just to show like how unhinged he is, because he washed his hands while they were still in the gloves. Which was crazy, man. This was a wonderful, wonderful movie and a great suggestion. Thank you for suggesting this movie. I enjoyed it thoroughly, sincerely. I want to thank you guys for watching the video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this reaction. If there's anything else that you guys would like for me to react to in reference to movies, please put it in the comments below, and I promise you I will get to everything in a timely manner.